Bonjour.
Hello.
J'ai la chance de profiter.
It's a beautiful spring day in the Arkema site at Jarry. I'm with Monsieur Vincent, who is the head of communications. So, Jarry is south of Grenoble, in the southeast of France. This plant employs approximately 340 people and specializes in the manufacturing of oxygenated products, chlorine, and its derivatives. It delivers about 500,000 tons of final products every year. I have learned that these products are used in pulp bleaching, water treatment, pharmaceuticals, and even aerospace. So, a little question for you. How many electric motors does it take to run this plant? You have 3 seconds to answer. It takes about 1,000 of them, working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And we can't afford any kind of breakdown. So, how are they monitored? And how are they protected? We have an appointment with Jérôme Dubois, who is the project manager on the Jarry chemical platform.
Hello, Monsieur Poix.
Thank you for welcoming me to this Arkema site.
It's a pleasure to meet you. Put your goggles on.
Okay, tell me, these 1,000 engines, what are they for?
Well, they're for applications based on a variety of domains. In this example, we have a motor that drives a pump for filling a tank that is linked to a manufacturing process. We have other pumps that are related to site security, for example, pumps that prevent overflow in ditches, thus preventing major risks to the site.
Yes, safety is important. So tell me about their reliability.
So basically, electric motors are very robust. They have a lifetime of about 10 years. They can also be reconditioned, which can extend their lifetime to about 20 years. However, such motors must be constantly monitored and protected to avoid any type of accident, of which there are principally two types: engine failure and the risk of a fire breaking out.
Motors are exposed to risks, so what are these risks?
There's the risk of short-circuiting, the risk of overloading due to a jammed pump or motor. There can also be insulation problems relating to the metal casing of the motor.
Okay.
You're also exposed to the threat of lightning on the plant.
And so, in practice, how do you protect your motors against each of these risks?
So, we choose the appropriate protection. To illustrate this, I suggest you go and look at a low-voltage electrical substation.
Okay, let's go.
We are in a low-voltage room which supplies the power for the motors for the site's steam production.
So, you mentioned these risks, and if we take a motor, how do we deal with each of these risks individually?
For short circuit protection, a magnetic circuit breaker is installed, which protects by disconnecting the power supply.
The Tesis GV2 and GV2LE circuit breakers cover power ratings up to 15 kilowatts, GV3L up to 45 kilowatts, GV4L and GV4LE up to 55 kilowatts.
It is also equipped with a contact that allows the fault status to be displayed on the front panel and in the control room.
Tesis GV circuit breakers can be equipped with a variety of accessories, such as auxiliary contacts, trip units, wiring accessories, and a remote handle.
We also have to ensure thermal protection against overloads. We've installed a thermal relay under the contactor, which can cut off the power supply to the contactor coil. It is relayed by a malfunction signal on the front panel and on the supervision screen, so we can easily reset it when the malfunction has been resolved.
Tesis LR thermal rays cover currents from 0.16 to 630 amperes. They have a stop and a reset button. They have a test button, an overload indicator, and terminals for controlling a contactor coil and external signaling. The relay must be adapted to the contactor. Tezos LR2K relay for a Tezos K contactor, LR8 or LR9D for a Tezos D contactor, and LR9F for a Tezos F contactor. The magnetothermal circuit breaker is an alternative solution for overload protection. It can be combined with short circuit protection. G2ME and GV2P circuit breakers up to 11 and 15 kilowatts. GV3P up to 45 kilowatts. GV4P and GV4PE up to 55 kilowatts. GV5P up to 110 kilowatts. And GV6P up to 260 kilowatts. These circuit breakers can also be equipped with the Tezos GV range of accessories.
The third challenge is the absence of a phase, the loss of power supply. The current of the other two phases will increase. The overload protection provided by the thermal relay will trip the contactor. Same principle. The failure will be relayed and sent back to the supervision screen with the possibility of resetting on phase return.
The thermal relay protects against imbalances and phase absences when the motor drives its normal load. Thermal magnetothermal circuit breakers also monitor phase loss.
And we monitor our entire low voltage distribution through a permanent installation controller that monitors the entire low voltage panel.
All right, what about the motors?
In addition to this, fault locators have been integrated to monitor the insulation of the motor, circuit by circuit.
The Visualome IM400 measures and displays the insulation resistance of an electrical installation. The Visualome IM-DIF-L12 has replaced the XD12. With its current cores, it can monitor 1 to 12 motor circuits. LEDs are used to locate insulation faults. The monitoring of insulation faults can be complemented by the protection of persons who may accidentally touch the motor. The GV4PEM circuit breaker incorporates a device that trips in the event of an insulation failure of the circuit it protects. It also protects against short circuits and overloads. So we still have one element that's not likely to happen today, that is lightning.
Yes, so our panels are equipped with surge protectors. These are installed at the transformer output on the whole low voltage distribution. And this protects the whole power electronics part of the distribution.
Okay, this is slightly outside of the scope of engine protection, but we can discuss this subject next time. In any case, I thank you for these very clear explanations, Monsieur Dubois. During our meeting with Mr. Dubois, he explained to us exactly how he used to monitor and protect his motors. There is a very special way to perform all its functions in a single box. It's called Tezos U. Let's discover it. Tezos U starters are suitable for three-phase motors up to 15 kilowatts. They protect against short circuits, overloads, phase loss, insulation defects. They allow direct on-off control or reversed control with two directions of rotation. Modules fit into the Tezos U base block to enable the following functions: protection and control, alarm, communication, display of electrical values. Auxiliary contacts can also be added to it and extend the handle. I hope this presentation has made you want to learn more about Tezos U. Just click on the link that appears at the top of the screen, and I hope to see you again soon.